Hi friends, I'll show you how to make ash gourd yogurt curry. This is very traditional in my family. We eat a lot this curry. You can just like that you can eat this one. You don't need anything. It's like basically like a raita based curry. So here is the ash gourd. In Tamil we call it vellai pusnikai. In Telugu they say it boodha gumidikai. In English it's ash gourd. So there will be shades of white ashes on top. I have rinsed it, so it's gone now. I have chopped this one. So how you have to use this vegetable is you have to peel the skin out. You have to actually slice it with the knife, and then there are seeds in this, so you have to remove the seeds and the sponge part. So if you see here, I have removed the seeds and the sponge part that's around the seeds, and I have used only this part of the vegetable. So I have chopped it into 1-inch chunks, and these are the ingredients needed for this curry. Yogurt 1 cup, 1 little large cup, and then I'm going to use coconut oil. These are the ingredients for tempering in coconut oil. Mustard seeds, cumin seeds, split urad dal. You can skip this if you don't want to use any lentils in this recipe. And then dry red chilies, 2 curry leaves, hing. These are the ingredients we are going to temper. And to garnish, cilantro, salt, few shallots I have chopped into small chunks. After we temper this, we are going to saute the onions also. So here I have 3 ingredients here. This is coconut, 2 tablespoons, green chilies, 4, cumin seeds. I'm going to grind this into coarse, and I'm going to add to the vegetables. First, we are going to boil the vegetables with salt. So here I have ready. I have boiled the vegetable with salt, and I have grinded these 3, coconut, green chilies and cumin seeds, and I have added that also in that. And the salt is just enough salt for the vegetables, is added when vegetable was cooked. So I'm going to mix this. Let it cool down. You don't have to boil it. Just cook the vegetable and then add the ground coconut, green chilies and cumin, and then just mix it. This has cooled down. Now I'm going to add yogurt to this curry. We have to make sure the vegetable cools down, because otherwise the yogurt will get into, like, it curdles in the hot vegetable. So I'm just mixing the yogurt, and I'm going to do the tempering with all of these, and I'm going to add and adjust the salt. Let's add cilantro also to this now, and I'm going to do the temper and then mix it. That's it, the vegetable is done. This curry will be very tasty just to eat like that. Very cooling, and you all know that this ash gourd is like kind of a tasteless actually. In whatever gravy you put it, it absorbs the taste and it gives that taste. This itself has no taste actually. Let me show you after I do the tadka. So I have mixed the salt, cilantro and vegetables, everything together. Now I'm going to add this tadka. This rice itself will go good. It goes with all different items like upma and all those varieties, and it also goes with rice also. So we can even make, like, you can saute eggplants, small eggplants, brinjals, and you can add, instead of this vegetable, you can saute the eggplants and onions, and then you can add to this curry. That also tastes good. So that's it. Ash gourd yogurt curry is ready.